Good morning everyone. Myself Neha Shwani from Mount Literacy School Jhansi. Today I'll be teaching you EVS Chapter 1 Family First School. Now before starting, let us recall what is family. A family is a group of people living together under one roof. Here we have a picture to show grandfather, father, mother, daughter, uncle. So, a family is a group of people living together under one roof. Now, why do we call family a first school? Because even before we start going to school, we learn many things at home. The small things that we are learning from our family members, our parents, grandparents, etc. Like brushing our teeth, tying our shoelaces. The school do not teaches us all these things. These things are taught to us by our family members. And along with these things, they also teaches us many difficult things like values, manners, and the most important, difference between right and wrong. They teach us what is right for us and what is wrong for us. Our parents, grandparents, uncle, aunt, and sometimes even our siblings are our first teacher. So family is our first school. Now coming to the most important topic, values. As a family, we live by certain values and ideas. These are known as family values. These values becomes the foundation of a family. And now let us have a look at few values that we uphold at home and in school. The first one, belongingness. All of us want to be loved and needed. We want that all our family members should love us. Even our teachers, our friends, we want all to love us. So this is known as feeling of belongingness, the value of belongingness. Now coming to the next one, flexibility. Our family takes certain decisions according to the needs and requirements of the family members. All the decisions should be made as a family, not as an individual. This is known as flexibility in decision making. Suppose our grandfather is taking the decisions, he is the head of the family. He must take the decisions, keeping in mind everyone, each and every member of the family. Now, coming to the next one, respect. We must not only respect our family members, but the people at work, workplace, school, and wherever we go. Like you are going to the party, you are going for picnic, wherever you are going, you should respect each and everyone. And not only our elders, we should give the respect to our younger ones too. Now you can see in the picture how these small kids are giving respect to the grandfather. Now, I hope you all do the same thing. Now coming to the next one, honesty. Honesty is the foundation of every relationship. Whether it is father-daughter relationship, husband-wife relationship, mother-son relationship, all the family members should be honest to each other. When they all are honest to each other, relationships become stronger and even they last forever. Now coming to the another point, open communication. It is the most important value. Whenever you want to tell anything to your parents, your grandparents, your family members, you should feel free to talk. Like you should not hesitate. Whatever you want to tell them, whatever happened with you, whatever are your hopes, your dreams, you should go and tell them everything. This is the most important value. In all the families, all the members should have a right to say. This is known as open communication. Now coming to the next topic, responsibility. Each family member should be responsible towards each other. All the families follow certain values and wants all the members to follow certain rules and regulations. We are responsible towards our grandparents, parents, and siblings, and even Our parents are responsible towards us and we are responsible towards them. Now, coming to another important point, physical characteristics. You must have noticed, like wherever you go, people say you look just like your father or your mother or your grandparents. So what is all this? These are the physical characteristics. Physical characteristic means like your eye color, your height, your color, your hair, the way you move, the way you talk, your anger, your smile. All these things are more or less way similar to your family members. We have these characteristics similar to them because of heredity. Now, what is heredity? Heredity is a process by which a baby inherits the characteristics of his or her parents. Now, we all look like our parents. We all follow certain values. Now, the next topic, appreciating qualities and skills of family members. Every member contributes to the well-being of the family. Every member plays a unique role in the family. All the members are important and the role played by them, you all should appreciate your parents, your grandparents, the work that they are doing daily, your mother, the hard work that she is doing in the kitchen the whole day, the household core, and your father, the work that he is doing for you, the whole day he is working in the office. Whatever they are doing for us. So we should appreciate them. We should appreciate the qualities, the skills. Our parents provide us with all the comforts, all the luxuries. They earn to give us comfortable life and good education. And in return, we should also play our part. We should be appreciating. We should thank them for little things. Each family member play his or her role willingly and happily. And at the same time, to appreciate the role played by others. Now, just have a look at this picture. So what is this? This is a family tree. Most important topic. Family tree. What is a family tree? You can see this is a tree. Here we have a picture of family members. Like father, mother, daughter, son. You all can also do it at home. You have to just make one tree and stick the pictures of your family members. Now, let us come to the... Okay, so now here we have some question answers related to a chapter. Question 1. What is a family? A family consists of a group of people living together under one roof. We all live together like a parents, grandparents, siblings, cousins. It can be that you are living in a joint family or a nuclear one. But we all live together under one roof and thus it is known as a family. Question 2. Why should we be thankful to our parents? We should be thankful to our parents for their constant love and support in the day-to-day life. Like, they help us, they love us, they support us for whatever we want to do. Without their support, we cannot do anything. So for that, we should be thankful to them. Next question, what do you understand by heredity? Heredity is a process by which a baby inherits the characteristics of his or her parents. A baby just looks similar to the parents just because of heredity. Children, just recall all the answers and if you want, you can also note it down, you can pen it down and just recall all the things that I have taught you in this chapter. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.